And welcome to our on-site studio.
Oh, thank you very much, and thank you for having me here.
Okay, so I know you were handing over prizes, but how proud were you of giving the first prize to two South Africans, to Gift Kelehe and Caroline Vosman?
Well, that's awesome. You know, over the years, we've always asked ourselves the question, why is it that in our own event we're spectators? And we know that many of our South Africans have tried very hard to be up there, and they've done it in the past. We know Bruce Fordyce and all those people have done it in the past. So what we have been losing in the past couple of years is to ask, why is it outsiders who win? And today, it's really one of those wow days for South African sports, to have the first man and the first woman over the line, South Africans, and that can only make this event bigger and motivate quite a number of athletes, road runners and ultra marathon runners to come back here and also know that it can be done.
As much as we have runners that will serve as an inspiration and as role models for younger people, we also have an event that epitomizes everything that I think the South African sporting community and that South Africa wants to be, you know, this united, diverse, passionate, dedicated, brave society. And that's kind of what you see at the Comrades, isn't it?
Well, that's it. If you look back here and you look at the people here, it's diverse. They come from different backgrounds. They're a mixed bag, as we would say in sport. And all of them gel together at this event. And I think for us in South African sport, where we constantly say that we have to get our people out there and be participating in sport, this is a great example. But over and above that, you know, for me, the beauty of this is that in as much as it brings so many people back together, it also plows back. The amount that goes into charity is just unbelievable. And you know, everyone, even if you are not running, but by making a contribution to what is happening here, you are actually showing South Africans that you are part of it. You don't have to be on the road, but we would like you to be on the road. And so here we are, and we see this diverse nature of the people here. And we're really excited because we want the nation to be playing. And the nation at play is a nation that really keeps itself fit and out of trouble.
It gets everybody excited. On race day, everybody says, you know, one day I'm going to do that race. Even our dear Minister of Sports and Recreation, I saw that he tweeted that he's going to do the Comrades next year.
No, we must hold him to it. He tweeted that next year you will be in there. I said to him, I'll join you on condition that you also bring Tabi Reddy along. So, we're in. So, if he keeps to his word, you will see me running next to him. So, I need to do this big one. I've done half marathon in Two Oceans. I've done this half marathon in Soweto run. So maybe I should give this a break and say, go into it, and you know, then you can sign it off and say, done. Just as I said, one day I'll cycle the 94.7. I did it last year, so it tick off. This must come.
Just so that you can say you can do it, because it's something that every South African should do.
Oh, it is. I mean, you know, I looked this morning as they started off, they said, the eldest man in the race is 80. You know, I just cringe a little bit, ashamed of myself, you know. Then they said the oldest woman is 72. And I said, no, come on, Gideon, this can't be that bad. So yes, I'm inspired. By being here for this, I'm inspired. So watch me next year.
Sure. National TV, Mr. Gideon Sam.
Hello. I know I've said many things on TV, you know. I'll bring so many medals and then I don't bring it. So hopefully this time around, nobody's going to hold me to it. I can get injured, you know this?
No, but okay, well, let's not try and think of excuses just yet. I mean, just as long as your heart and your intention is there. But you want my honest opinion. I think you and your committee are just too busy to be putting in the hours that you need to for the Comrades Marathon, because you've got that little thing called the Commonwealth Games 2022 bid.
Oh, yes, yeah. I think between now and in the next 7 years, it's going to be hard work. The committee that we've put together to make sure that we we put up a very, very good Commonwealth game for the Commonwealth. It's going to be immense. And already, you know, we have not even gone to Auckland for the 2nd of September to get the endorsement of the General Assembly. And these guys are spending hours and hours on the bid, cleaning up the bid and making sure that we satisfy the voting assembly. But over and above that, we still have to host them there. They're all coming here. The Americas, Asia, Oceania, all of them are coming to South Africa. And so it's going to be hard work. And you're quite correct. It's going to be hours and hours for a small committee to do this.
I mean, you're already speaking as if we got the nod.
Well, it's a one-man race. You see, the thing is that there's only one horse in the race. And all we have to do is, after the coordination commission visit last month, you know, they were happy and they said, only that little bit. So we're working on that little bit. They will write a report. It will go to all the general, to the Commonwealth Games Associations. They will come and have a look for themselves. And when we go to Auckland, we are really, really saying to South Africans, those people will vote in our favor. It's never been to Africa, and all of them feel that it's time for us also to host.
I know that the bid committee, you guys have got a communications team, and I follow them on Twitter and I see them on other social media. They're very active and they've been retweeting some things about the Comrades Marathon. They were there with a little store at the expo, which opened on Thursday and closed last night. What does the Comrades mean? Or, I mean, what kind of advert is the Comrades Marathon for the rest of the world to show them that, yes, we can host the rest of the world. We are open, and once again, it's just another event in the right direction for South Africa. We've hosted so many great sports events, you know, but hosting these things on a regular basis and letting them go off without a hitch, I'm sure it has to be a very good advert for the rest of the world.
This is a good advert for South Africa. The most important thing in world sport is you must be able to showcase what you can do. And here is a great example of what South Africans can do. The organization, it's on time, and there's no hiccup. The roads are clear, security is there, and these are the things that count in your favor. Going towards 2022, we will have to put up many of these kind of events. The doozy must become bigger. It's international. The Amashova cycling, that must become bigger, because the Mitma must become bigger, because these are all the events that we need to use to showcase what it is that we can do as South Africans. And I'm excited to see what is happening here, because when you go to an event, you want to see what the organizers, how they've gone about putting it together. And when you get to the point where it is a medal ceremony and you see how slick it is, then you know that these people have done fantastically well. But over and above that is what the South African spectators are doing. I mean, you see here, they didn't run away after the first 10. They're still cheering in those who are coming in, because they want to see the cutoff date, cutoff time, and see what happens there. On the roads, they were out there. And that is this kind of a spirit that we need to build. And I can assure you that in the coming years, these kind of events, we will have to say to South Africans, support in big numbers, because it showcases what we're doing.
Mr. Sam, what we're seeing now, and a big reason why everybody is going so crazy, is because of this massive, massive bus that is coming over the finish line here at the Pietermaritzburg Oval. This is, of course, the Bill Rowan bus. And they have got 6 minutes today, a very comfortable Bill Rowan medal. And that is hugely significant for these people to get that beautiful medal, which is a mixture between silver as well as bronze. And then following 9 hours, then it's going to be in the bronze medal. Those athletes that come in after 9 hours, they'll be receiving a bronze medal. But for these athletes, for that massive bus that came over, they're going to be receiving a Bill Rowan medal. And for the next 5.5 minutes, we have got athletes that are going for that. We're going to have a big countdown here, and it's very, very loud. Part of what you were speaking about, Mr. Sam, that actually actually we need the support, but more than that, we need the spirit of volunteerism. Need South Africans to actually volunteer for stuff.
Now, but you see, what you see around here, it's volunteers that make this possible. And as we build towards 2022, that culture of volunteerism, which we already have in South Africa, will just become bigger and bigger to ensure that no event suffers because people are standing and folding their arms and saying, let somebody else do it. They come forward, and they do, and they work, and we've seen it here. These are hundreds and hundreds of people working here for the love of the sport. And without them, sport cannot really triumph. This is what we need, and this is what we see happening here, is what our people... Just listen to the cheering here. I mean, if all of them sat at home and didn't come out to come and support, we would not be here. And the volunteers go down here, look at what is happening behind the scenes. The guys who are the car guys, everybody there is putting in their little bit because we want to make sure it works. It must work for South Africa.
Lovely, sir. Thank you very much. That's SASCOC President Mr. Gideon Sam chatting to us and also saying that he one day will run the Comrades Marathon along with the Minister of Sport and Recreation, who said he too has been taken by the vibe that we've seen today with two South African winners and would also like to do the Comrades Marathon. We are building up towards the gun of the Bill Rowan medals, and there is a legend that's going to be firing that gun, a man that celebrates the 50th anniversary that he actually won the race, Mr. Bernard Gomesol, who is in South Africa from America. He is visiting the race, and he's going to be firing that gun to mark the closure of those Bill Rowan medals. These people are